God, be gracious unto me, the sinner. O God, be gracious unto me, the sinner. O God, be gracious unto me, the sinner. Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Holy God, visit and heal our infirmities. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. God is shown us light. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. God is the Lord, and hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. All nations compassed me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them. God is the Lord which hath shown us light. Blessed is he that cometh in the name. I shall not die but live, and declare the works of the Lord. God is the Lord which hath shown us light. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. The stone which the builders refused is become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. God is the Lord which hath shown us light. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. As acceptable victims and fleshly picked flowers, as divine first fruits and newborn lambs, you were offered to Christ, who was born as a child, O most pure children. You mocked the wickedness of Herod, and now we beseech you unceasingly to pray for our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as acceptable victims and freshly picked flowers, as divine first fruits and newborn lambs, you were offered to Christ, who was born as a child, O most pure children. You mock the wickedness of Herod, and now we beseech you unceasingly, pray for our souls, both now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Today the bonds of barrenness are broken, for God has heard the prayers of Joachim and Anna. He has promised them, beyond all their hopes, to bear the maiden of God, by whom the uncircumscribed word was born as a mortal man, who commanded an angel to cry to her, rejoice, O full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Holy John the Baptist, pray to God for us. Perceiving the Master born in thy womb, O pure Mother of God, John as his forerunner leapt for joy in his mother's womb. Holy innocents, pray to God for us. Today the contest opens for the babes who are faithful to Christ our God, and they denounce the princes and authorities of the enemy, manfully reproving Herod's infantile rage. Most holy Theotokos, save us. The temple of the divine Savior is contained and formed in her mother's womb. The ladder is set up that leads all men on high, whose conception we honor with faith. Holy John the Baptist, pray to God for us. Break apart the stoniness of my mind, O forerunner, as of old that it's loose the bonds of the barren, and cause me to increase the fruits of repentance and to live forever. Holy innocent, pray to God for us. When thou wast born, O Christ, immortal, multitude of innocents joined battle today with their blood, arming themselves mightily against Herod. And so we all cry out in song, bless the Lord, all ye works of the Lord. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Raise me up who lie in the abyss of evils, and vanquish the enemies now raging, now engaging me in battle. Though I am wounded by the pleasures of sin, do not disdain me, O good and pure lady, but take pity and save me. Holy John the Baptist, pray to God for us. Throwing wide the gates of the barren woman, the great and divine forerunner of Christ takes his abode within his mother's womb, as within royal chambers, that he may go forth as a warrior, preparing the way for the King of all. Holy innocents, pray to God for us. There is heard Rachel's bitter lamentation, her weeping, contrition, and cries of alas for vile Herod, the murderous enemy has slain the children of Bethlehem. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Dance all ye people and leap up, for the earth has been prepared, which, though never plowed, will produce the life-bearing grain, eating of which those who magnify his goodness will hunger no longer. It is truly meet and right to bless thee, O on us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Furthermore, we pray for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, our Bishop Thomas, and all our brotherhood in Christ. Lord, Furthermore, we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and our armed forces. Kyrie visitation and furtherance in all the evil of abortion and to work for the pardon and remission of their sins. Soften the hearts of those who seek destruction, rescuing them, Lord. We humbly pray, Lord, hearken and mercy. Furthermore, we pray for mothers and fathers who are tempted by the world or expose their unborn children to the instruments of torture, that the voices of darkness may be silenced, that peace and acceptance may reign, and that new life may be welcomed and nurtured. We pray thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken thee and have mercy. Furthermore, we pray for all women who have abortions and for their families, that they may receive healing and grace with assurance of thy boundless mercy and forgiveness. We pray thee, O compassionate Savior, hear us and have mercy. Furthermore, we pray for those who by word or action support and promote the great scourge of abortion in this land, that thou wouldst correct their thoughts, open their eyes, and soften their hearts. We pray thee, O Lord, hearken and have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We pray that the Lord God will hearken to the voice of supplication of us sinners and have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. O God, our Savior, thou hope of all the ends of the earth, and for those who are far off upon the sea. And have mercy, O God, upon us sinners, and be merciful to us. For thou art a merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. O Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, who art in the bosom of the Father, fountain of life and immortality, light of light, who camest into the world to enlighten it. Thou wast pleased to be conceived in the womb of the Virgin Mary for the salvation of our souls by the power of thine all-holy Spirit. O Master, who camest that we might have life more abundantly, we beseech thee to enlighten the minds and hearts of those who refuse to acknowledge that human life begins at conception, and that the unborn in the womb are already adorned with thine image and likeness. Grant us strength to guard, cherish, and protect the lives of all those who are unable to care for themselves. For thou, O giver of life, dost bring each person from non-being into being, sealing each person with divine and infinite love. Be merciful, O Lord, to those who, through ignorance or willfulness, affront thy divine goodness and provide through the evil and thy divine goodness and providence through the evil act of abortion. May they, with all of us, come to the life of thy truth and glorify thee, the merciful Savior, together with thy Father, who is without beginning, and thine all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Wisdom, most holy Theotokos, save us, more honorable than the cherub. And more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, thou who without sin merest God the word, and art truly Theotokos, be magnified. Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Father.
May he who was born in a cave and lay in a manger and baptized by John in the Jordan for our salvation, Christ our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the holy, of the honorable and glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious and all laudable apostles, especially the holy apostle Philip, of the holy innocent children slain by Herod, of the holy blessed Xenia of St. Petersburg, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen.
I have two thoughts to share, and then we'll sing Memory Eternal for the repose of the infants slain by abortion, and many years for all who work for life. But before that, an amazing thought that comes when we read, especially the Sermon on the Mount, right? God is our Father. That's the thrust of the Sermon on the Mount. We are sons and daughters of God. And in that, everything is turned upside down. Life is upside down. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are you when you are persecuted. Everything's upside down. The world says, blessed are you rich and you healthy, successful, happy. But God says opposite. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And we see that that has happened, and the prayers recognize this. That has happened with the holy innocents. We think of the tragedy fueled by Herod's weakness and fear of killing the 14,000, the 14,000 little boys under 2 years of age in his trying to eradicate the newborn king. We think of that as a tragedy, and it is, just like the tragedy of abortion. But in God's perspective, they're not just victims, they're victors. And we ask them to pray for us. The tragedy has been turned on its head, just like the tragedy of Christ on the cross becomes the victory. The tragedy of the victim becomes victory. So too the tragedy of the babies. As tragic, as awful as it is here, it's a victory. They get to go to heaven early. None of them will be will be baptized in the font, but they're baptized in their own blood. And so I think we need to have, spiritually speaking, we need to have, of course, the worldly response of, what can we do to stop this evil in our land? And it was around the time, you know, that abortion was legalized, that the rest of the country, all the country started to fall apart. It's around that same time, and we can notice that. We can also notice that even in California, where they have the strictest COVID precautions, they have the worst cases, because it's out of California, all the badness comes to our land. Right? Sin is abounding there. So we can notice that, and we should fight against it. We should do everything that we can to raise awareness of the sanctity of life, to work against legal abortion, and also to convince and encourage people, mothers with crisis pregnancies, that their babies are worth saving. We need to do all of that. But spiritually speaking, we need to put ourselves within the realm, the fatherhood of God, and recognize these victims as victors. Recognize that they are ahead of us. They're not the weak ones. They are the vulnerable ones in this world. But in heaven, they're the strong ones. They're the ones who gave their life, the life that they didn't even have in their own possession yet. And they gave it. And they're ahead of us. It's just crazy to think about that. Everything's turned upside down. I know I said I had two thoughts, but I think I just had one. I can't remember what the second one is. Okay, so we'll stand and sing Memory Eternal. And we're asking them to pray for us. Again, by God's providence, they are baptized in their own blood. Grant rest, O Lord, in blessed repose to the souls of your servants who have been slain by abortion, and make their memories to be eternal. And all good things to your servants who work and suffer for life, and grant them many blessed years. God grant you many years. good today is a fast day. We should be fasting with this in mind too.